again, Bill Pfeiffer speaking from Marysville. Do press the subscribe and like button, like if you like, and share it with others. A good thing. I might recommend a thing that Cindy and I are now watching on, I think it's on Prime, called Simply Chosen. A really nice explanation of the things that happened around Jesus and all of the things we read about in the Bible. Just very, very well done. Nothing mushy or whatever, but extremely well done. And I recommend it to you. It's really good, and you'll enjoy it. Another film that I've mentioned before, Sister Claire, All or Nothing, and another one about the monks in Chartreuse in Grenoble in France. It's called Into Deep Silence. Into Deep Silence. It's almost done completely in silence, but it's really something that'll touch your heart. Today I was just looking at a reading a book last night, and one of the captions at the head of one of the chapters said, "Telling is not training." That's advice given by executive coaches. Telling is not training. So telling doesn't train people to do anything. Telling is not doing. You know, telling is not experiencing. Telling is not having it happen for you if it has not happened for you. You know, if it hasn't happened for you, it hasn't happened at all. Isn't that true? Not really. Words, 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 sermons, homilies, books, papers, magazines, articles, talk, huh? And nothing really changes. You know, the fact is, information, education, exhortation, inspiration, an explanation are not transformation. Not transformation, huh? They have value in some ways, but they're not transformation. Recently, the Catholic bishops, for example, have launched a 3-year program to kind of rescue belief in the Eucharist. More words, documents, talks, homilies, you know? In 3 years, little will change. Saving the Save programs, on the other hand, like Crucio, the Acts program, Charismatic Renewal, these kinds of programs always work because they gave the participants an experience. You know, telling is not training. They gave them an experience of God, Jesus, the power of the Holy Spirit, religion alive, shared by people who were directly and already living the excited, meaningful Christian life. Learning from a book about swimming is not the same as jumping into the water and actually swimming. I'm not trying to compare swimming, Christianity, and whatever, and God's grace. I'm not doing that. God can do wonders in certain situations, but the way He works normally is by helping people to experience His presence alive in their lives and transforming them. Richard Rohr, a Franciscan priest, kind of a hero of mine, a great spiritual, theological, scriptural, cultural, psychological, philosophical leader, and much more. The author of many groundbreaking books, New York Times bestsellers, founder of the most influential Center for Action and Contemplation in Albuquerque, New Mexico, recently had a personal meeting with the Pope, one-on-one. Father Rohr brought a copy of his latest incredible book entitled The Universal Christ to give to the Pope, but the Pope said he had already read it. And 3 times in the course of their meeting, he said, "I want you to continue doing what you're doing, continue teaching what you're teaching." The conversation mostly focused, Father Rohr said, on the importance of how the rediscovery of the contemplative mind, experience, prayer experience, a real encounter with God, can serve the renewal of Christianity and heal our whole world. They're right. They're absolutely right, you know. And I'd love to, Father Rohr kind of has the wisdom, the depth, and the spiritual maturity that all 75-year-old people only hope to possess. Dynamite, just absolutely dynamite. Let me finish with a nice little allegory called the dragonfly. In a little pond in the muddy water under the lily pads, there lived a little water beetle in a community of water beetles. They lived a simple and comfortable life in the pond with few disturbances and interruptions. Once in a while, with sadness, would come someone to the community when one of their fellow beetles would climb the stem of a lily pad and would never be seen again. They knew when this happened, their friend was dead and gone forever. Then one day, one little water beetle felt an irresistible urge to climb up that stem. However, he was determined that he would not leave forever. He would come back and tell his friends what he had found at the top. When he reached the top and climbed out of the water onto the surface of the lily pad, he was so tired and the sun felt so warm that he decided he must take a nap. As he slept, his body changed, and when he woke up, he had turned into a beautiful blue-tailed dragonfly with broad wings and a slender body designed for flying. So fly he did, and as he soared, he saw the beauty of a whole new world and a far superior way of life to what he had ever known existed. Then he remembered his beetle friends and how they were thinking by now he was dead. He wanted to go back and tell them and explain to them that he was now more alive than he had ever been before. His life had been fulfilled rather than ended. God, we don't believe that. But his new body would not go down into the water. He could not get back to tell his friends the good news. Then he understood that their time would come, hopefully, when they too would know what he now knew. So he raised his wings and flew off into his joyous new life. Transformed people transform people. You know, the things, the junk inside of us that we've acquired from our parents, from the schools that have taught us, sometimes from the church, our ethnic group, the culture, and so on, all of that junk, if it isn't transformed, it gets transmitted. And that's a really sad thing from one generation to the other. So remember the dragonfly. It took a risk, but he risked it and found out for himself, not just telling, but training. You know, not just telling, but the experience. And that's what really changed his life. And now he's able, transformed, to go back and to touch and transform others, not only by his message, but by his very life itself. Happiness tomorrow truly always depends on doing the truth today. Good to be with you. Keep me in your thoughts and prayers. You're in mine. God bless.